And we are back here in the Jacobs High School gym. It's the Hinkle Holiday Classic. I'm Brandon Giese alongside Ryan Weiss, and we're going to bring you some live action basketball here. It's the Grant Community High School versus the Lakes Community High School, both community high schools. The Lakes Eagles, they have a couple of good scorers, but the main guy is Kyle Rohr. He's had a great tournament so far. He's piled it up. He scored a nice 20 points in one of their previous efforts, and also for the opposition, you like to see James Mobley on the board. Scored 14 for them when they played the Cary Grove Trojans in a win then. This is the Consolation B Bracket Championship. And here they come. John Kerr will jump against Jordan McCure. Here they come. James Mobley will take the ball up right to left. A lot quicker pace we're seeing already just in this first 15 seconds than we saw in the whole last game. Far side, that's Ben Cusiak. James Mobley for three. Back rim no good. Rebound controlled. And Kyle Rohr will bring it up for the Community Eagles. Kyle Rohr, good basketball player. Knows how to fill it up, Ryan. James Mobley right to left. Here he comes. He comes in nice and easy. No good. Cusiak with a move underneath. Didn't have it go. Colton Jules coming back left to right. He gives it up to Kyle Rohr. Far side and up fake. Far side swing. Jordan McCure could not finish. Pass down low, Andy Kay. John Kerr for two. Back rim no good. John Kerr, a 6'5 forward, looks every bit of that. It's gonna be a foul called. Minute and 20 seconds in, what do you see so far?
My stat sheet.
Kyle Rohr with it now. Gets it right back, wanted to fire but didn't have a good enough look. Jordan McCure brings it in, and Jordan McCure, first bucket of this game, gets the Lakes Community Eagles on the board. James Mobley gives it up. Logan Lewis. Andy Kay. Mobley, a dribble drive, gives it up. A beautiful pass, and the layup is blown by Andy Kay.
That was a very good look there. You cannot ask for anything. That was tailor-made, they would say, in golf.
Gives it up, Jordan McCure with it now. McCure, another dribble drive, through some contact, and Jordan McCure looks to be playing like a man possessed. A lot of different ways to pronounce Jordan's last name, but I believe the coach told me McCure.
Here on the sheet it says, it reads Mercer, but the coach knows the kid, so let's go with McCure.
Second one is up and in.
McCure, only man on the board.
4 points for him. We got the scoreboard running with the points on it this time.
Must be because it's the championship game here.
Lewis gives it up to Cusiak. Cusiak definitely looked like he walked there. They're not going to give it. Mobley fires. James Mobley gets on the board.
Looks like the active man for Grant is going to be James Mobley down there, number 23.
McCure again.
Oh.
Logan Lewis for three. Back rim tapped around and controlled. Kyle Rohr will bring it up. A wild one there. Rebound and an and one for Timothy Olwine.
One thing I love to see on the bench down there is the Lakes Community Eagles bench is very loud. They're very active. I mean, you can see it right there. They're already getting out to half court. Just the energy that they have is remarkable.
Yep, definitely hyping up the players on the floor. 8-2 here in the Jacobs High School gym, 4:41 remaining. It's the first quarter of the Consolation B Bracket Championship. And so far, Lakes Community Eagles control the game.
Yeah, I mean, there's something earlier in the games today. I did a game two games ago.
Apparently, we are going to replay of that and one. A rebound by Olwine underneath the hoop, and he just took an easy and one there.
Yeah, he not much there to muscle up there, but he did his job, and he's going to go for the and one right here to make it a 9-2 ball game in favor of the Lakes Community Eagles.
Olwine, that one's good. The three-point play, the classic way.
The easy way, some might say.
The and one opportunity. Lewis gives it up. Far side, that's Kyle Dupree. He checked in. Also another sub, that's gonna be Drew Walker. Lewis dribble drive. Gives it back to Kay. Looks like there was some contact there, but they let that one play out. Kyle Rohr brings it up. Swing pass, and they got a good look at it. For three, no good. Rebound controlled, and here comes Logan Lewis. Yeah, bad pass there, and a great play by McCure to keep it in play, and an easy layup there for Colton Jewell.
Jordan McCure has come to play today.
He's doing it all.
He really is. And that's just hustle points. He's got the points on the board playing defense. That's what you like to see out of a young man like that.
A stat that doesn't go on the sheet, hustle, that's for sure. Logan Lewis with a fall away. The 5'10 junior guard for the Grant Bulldogs knocked that fall away down. Oh, definitely a charge down there. Timothy Olwine was throwing the body around. Substitute checks in. That's number 31. Jack Christensen for the Eagles. Lewis now. Steph Curry-esque layup for Logan Lewis. Just run it in there, throw it up off the glass. Logan Lewis showing off some skills here with the fall away, and then on consecutive possessions, he brings it down and puts up a nice running layup. McCure dribble drive, that's a floater from him. Lewis with a big back tap there. That's a 5'10 guard getting up there to tap that ball out. Mobley gives it up.
I can tell you he does not like 5'10 from up here. He looks like it. Everybody at 5'6". But hey, he's getting up there.
Kyle Dupree for three, no good. That kind of rolls off the tongue. Dupree for three. Kyle Rohr now. Looking for a couple of screens there. And it's ripped up by Logan Lewis. He's having a great quarter so far. And that one's gonna be last off of a Lakes Community Eagle. In comes number 10 for Grant. That's going to be, excuse me, I don't believe we have.
Well, we do know for sure number 3 just came in for Lakes Community, and that's Demetrius Michaels.
Yeah, Demetrius Michaels checks in. We'll get back to you on that sub for the Grant Bulldogs. Sandy K puts that one up and in. I might have just been misspoken. I actually don't see a number 10 down there. McCure gives it up far side. Kyle Rohr for three, no good. Rebound. Controlled, and here comes James Mobley. Kay took a couple of steps without dribbling the ball. Pretty sure that's a walk, sir. Inside, Kay again, no good. Demetrius Michaels with the board.
Demetrius Michaels, he's the 5'7 guard. He's the one that's 5'6. Hey, give him an inch. He's almost at Logan Lewis's height.
Yeah, he looks like a little guy, that's for sure. Gives it up far side, Kyle Rohr. McCure says clear it out. Rohr with it. Pass into no man's land, and Dupree is out and running. Oh! You hear the viciousness of the slap there.
Yeah, I'd say that's a
that's a high five.
Yeah, that's a little aggressive.
Grant with the Jordan Brand jerseys. How do you think? I like that.
We got a couple of guys out there. The last game we had a little Jordan action too.
Oh yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That one is up and no good for Kyle Dupree. 24 checks in for Grant. That's going to be Nick Kovalis. Second one is up for Dupree. That one is no good as well. Dupree over 2 at the line on this trip.
Just under 1 minute left to go in this first quarter of the championship game of consolation.
Demetrius Michaels has a pass go right off his hands. And possession will go to the Grant High School Bulldogs now. 11-8, favor of the Lakes Community Eagles. James Mobley gets a good look at it, and he's gonna knock that one down. James Mobley, a very good scorer for the Grant Bulldogs. They like to spread it out, but James Mobley loves to score the basketball.
Yeah, Grant just took their lead down to 1. That is Lakes.
Michaels throws a pass right between the arms of Kyle Dupree. Rohr with it now. Gonna get a wild shot, but they're gonna call the walk on him first.
So far in this holiday tournament, there does not seem like there's a lot of scoring in this first quarter.
And not a powerhouse quarter, that's for sure. That's going to be a foul, and then, you know, that's a bad one. 3 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah.
That's a bad foul there. Number 24, Nick Kovalis, will get his first opportunity at the line. Kovalis lets that one go. And that one, it falls for Nick Kovalis. 11-11. Punts the ball off the floor and lets this one go. And Grant has a lead. 3 seconds remain. They're gonna probably flick up a heave here. A running heave, and that one hits the front rim. No good from Kyle Rohr. 12-11 in favor of the Grant High School Bulldogs. Got a couple of guys pitching in here. 4 from Lewis, 4 from Mobley, and then a pair of deuces from Kovalis and Kay. Besides that, that wraps up the scoring for them. Jewel with 2, 6 for McCure, and 3 for O-line. So once again, we see a 3-man show for the Lakes Community Eagles.
Yeah, but this time, the Lakes Community Eagles, they are seems to be winning, aren't they?
They're down by a bucket, but they controlled the period.
There you go.
Period. Quarter, I'm in hockey mode. They controlled the quarter.
11. My mistake. I messed up over here on my sheet. Can't trust it all, can you?
So far, it's been a pretty back and forth game. Do you think the offense would be a little bit more for how the tempo has been,
though?
are back, and we've got some subs. Steven Garrett will start the second quarter on the floor for the Eagles. And we've got some bantering going down here. We've seen this a couple times so far in this tournament. Not quite too sure what they could be checking. Is that the eligibility list?
I don't know who they would be checking because it's a even game.
Are they getting technical? Why are they getting technical free throws right now? This is something that I'm not quite too sure about. Andy Kay will go to the line and he will hit the first one. Why? I'm not too sure. It looks like there was some sort of substitution or, God, for the life of me, I wouldn't understand why.
Yeah, up here we are not able to either read the mouth or we don't get the information like the pros about what happened down there.
Yeah, we don't got our sideline reporter today. Nevertheless, Grant gets the easy technical free throws, and there's a three thrown up, and they knock it down, and just like that, it's a five-point swing. And I'm not
Drew Walker with the three on that one.
Too sure why, but it is indeed a five-point swing. A layup thrown up that was just a little too hard off the board by Steven Garrett.
Now what do we got going on?
Yeah, we got
there?
More stuff. More controversy here.
Looks like we got to be the sideline reporters today too. We got to do it all.
We're gonna do the job of three men here. I'm not too sure about all this. It's been bickering and bantering from the refs to the coaches to technical fouls to about everything you can think of. Mobley with the drive. Nowhere to go with the head. Dupree wide open, but he missed him. Dupree throws up a wild shot looking for contact, but they didn't give it to him. 17-11 here in the Jacobs High School gym. Steven Garrett's far side. Almost had that pass intercepted, but instead it's going to be a three-pointer knocked down. That's a sub that we didn't catch. That's number 15, Nicholas Garcia. Far side, that's Drew Walker. Walker gives it up to Mobley. Ball away from Mobley, no good. Andy Kay with a board. Good work by Andy Kay inside. Dribbled into the corner to Drew Walker. And Mobley's gonna pick that off. Not quick enough to get to it though.
Yeah, I mean from up here we can see it all developing. What's his face? James Mobley. He read that completely. That was completely telegraphed by Jordan McCure. He also had a really good first quarter.
That's going to be out of bounds. Last tipped by a red jersey. Lakes Community Eagles will retain possession. Inbound underneath the hoop. McCure gives it up. Walker with it now. Drew Walker gives it into the corner. Fire for three. Nicholas Garcia, no good. Jump ball, possession arrow points in favor of the Lakes Community Eagles.
Must have been a walk over there. Or was that a jump ball?
I believe it was a jump ball. Jump ball thrown there to Jordan McCure. He won it like a wide receiver. dribble drive by Garcia, gives it back. O-line to McCure. He's gonna draw some contact and he'll be going to the line. 19-14 in favor of the Grant High School Bulldogs. It's the Hinkle Holiday Classic. If you're just now joining us, I'm Brandon Giese alongside Ryan Weiss. We both hope you had a happy holidays. And now we're here to bring you some basketball. McCure misses the first one.
Yeah, McCure, after having a really, really solid first quarter, he looks a little shaky here. He committed a couple, a foul or two. I think it was one. He's got a 7 point of the day, so he definitely, he's one to look out for if he gets hot, because he's already got seven leading scores throughout the day right now.
He's got a big body and he uses it well. Quickly swung, Kyle Dupree far wing. Andy Kay backing in, throws up a wild shot. That's rebounded by Garcia. Gave it to McCure. Didn't want to risk a travel or a double dribble there just in case. Garcia for three, no good. He's not afraid to shoot now, is he?
He's not. I mean, he's made one, now he's one for three. But I mean, now we're moving sports again to baseball. 333 average, not too bad, huh?
Different sport.
As a high schooler shooting 33%, that's about, I'd say average. A little above average, would you say?
Yeah, probably above average on that line. Drew Walker for three.
What a funky shot.
Yeah, that was weird. Funky was a good word there. Or that was Steven Garrett's, I'm sorry. McCure now with it. Garcia gives it up. Inside, yeah, that's definitely a walk. Lost his footing there.
Yeah, sometimes when you're down to the basket right there, you know what you want to do inside your head. When you start dribbling the ball, sometimes it does not translate to the court. And then you just get, your mind starts thinking faster than your legs, and then you just get called to travel. And then in your head, you're like, I knew exactly what I was doing, too.
Lewis with another fall away. Wow, Logan Lewis. Hits the twine from the wing there. That was a nice follow away from Logan Lewis. Mobley lost his footing. A good defensive play by him. And Garcia with an up and under. A good finish from Nicholas Garcia.
Up and under over there, except under another defender.
Nicholas Garcia, 17-21 in favor of Grant. Logan Lewis far side, gives it up to Mobley. Andy Kay now gives it up to Mobley once again. Mobley for three, bang! James Mobley, nothing but the bottom of the net for James Mobley on the wing, and the answer on that three.
He's bringing his game today, folks.
Yeah, he definitely is feeling it so far. McCure had another good look at an and one, but he does not get it, so he'll be going to the line.
Still trying to figure out Jordan McCure's style of play. He just seems like he goes to the basket.
Kind of like a slasher.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. McCure throws that one up, and that one goes for him.
His third trip to the line.
Yeah, just one miss so far for him from the line. McCure, second one is up. Pretty much hit every part of that rim. That was a good board by Colton Jewell. Garcia with the steal. Wow, blew the layup. Thought he was gonna be more contested than he was.
That happens a lot in high school. When a lot of people don't know how to decelerate themselves, so they just go up kind of crazy and then they just glass is a lot harder than some think.
Lewis thought he was gonna fall away. Instead he passed Andy Kay. or excuse me, that was John Kerr, no good. Kaya Orr back in the game. Pass to Jordan McCure. McCure gets that one to go. McCure had a very solid game so far. That puts him in double digits with 10.
Mm-hmm. Does. 6 for the first quarter, 4 for the second.
Mobley on the wing, an up fake. Got, drew him some space, actually, and James Mobley. He's not going to miss that one.
What's his, what has he got?
9.
James Mobley. He's standing at 6'3", and the weight is blank, so. Tell you that one, folks.
Yeah, no weight on their roster. Jordan McCure, it's a two-man show
yeah,
right now.
You beat me to it.
McCure and Mobley.
M's.
Yep, the M's are, the, it's.
M and M's. For the holiday season, some candy, you know.
What are they, not quite too sure what happened there. They, maybe just some subs. I was looking at you. I wasn't paying attention. Mobley took a seat for the Bulldogs. Oh, that was a great pass. Nevertheless, barely
swatted.
Even touched it. Just kind of squatted it down to, I believe that was John Kerr under the rim.
That was a smart idea from a smart player.
Yeah, Logan Lewis, very very good young point guard. He pre-fires nothing. 22-26 here in the Jacobs High School gym. It's the Grant Bulldogs leading the Lakes Community Eagles right now. Kyle Rohr for 3. Bang! Kyle Rohr hits nothing but the bottom of the net, and now it is a 1-point game in favor of the Grant Bulldogs. Kerr with it. Inside Dupree. That one goes for Kyle Dupree.
Strong second quarter by both teams.
Yeah, for sure. On offense, it's been a hot quarter for both teams.
After finishing the first quarter, 12-11 in favor of the Grant Bulldogs, now it's 25-28 in favor of the Lakes Community Eagles with much faster pace game. It seems like it's way more fun to watch than some of those quarters that just drag on when there's turnovers and fouls. And
yeah, that's for sure. A lot of action here. Oh, it's got to be something. Out of bounds. Another time where we're only seeing 4 guys in the scoring column for the Eagles.
Yeah, but this time we're on the winning end.
Excuse me, 5 in the scoring column. Lewis gets it inside to Kyle Dupree. Dupree's going to throw up that. I don't know how that went in, but it did. Kyle Dupree with the bucket, 25-30.
That's one of those shots that you're playing street ball in, one of those horse shots because you don't think you can make it. But he definitely made it.
Miracle worker Kyle Dupree. Rohr with the answer, no good. Thought about saving it, but just let it go after he had no one around. They're going to check James Mobley and Ben Cusiak back in.
For the remaining 6 seconds of this game.
Try to get him the ball, maybe get a bucket here. I don't know. Up by 5, so they're looking for something here with James Mobley, most likely. Lewis is running out of time. He's gonna give it to Kerr. Kerr's gonna fire with time. Oh, off the side part of the rim. And that's gonna be the half. 25-30 in favor of the Grant High School Bulldogs. Pretty good showing for both teams so far. A close game nevertheless. And we're gonna crunch some numbers for you real quick, get you a scoring update.
I got Grant, if you wanna take Lakes for me. I got Grant with Lewis Logan with 6, James Mobley with 7, and Andy Kay with 6, and then Dupree with 4, Walker with 3, and then at the bottom we got Nick Bayless with 2.
And for the Lakes Community Eagles, we got 2 from Jewel, 12 from McCure, 3 from Roar, 3 from Timothy Olwine on that and one earlier, and a 5 spot from Nicholas Garcia is gonna wrap that scoring up. We're gonna send it to a quick break. We'll bring it back to you with just about a minute left to bring you a little bit of analysis from our great color man, Ryan Weiss. It's the Hinkle Holiday Classic. I'm Brandon Giese for Ryan Weiss. We'll see you in just a little bit. All right, guys, let's bring this thing back. And we are back here at the Hinkle Holiday Tournament. I'm Brandon Giese alongside Ryan Weiss bringing you some live action basketball. Ryan's got a little analysis to bring you guys about the first half, why this game is the way it is.
Yeah, I mean, so far we got Mobley, or James Mobley and Jordan McCure. They're the ones that have been, I guess, taking the game away, and it's been fun to watch them two go back and forth. Even though Mobley only has 7 points, he's been in on almost every point, it seems like, when he's on the court. And it's just fun to watch when it's going back and forth. When the game's 30-25, normally in a high school game, it's more normally in the 20s or so. And then the second half is normally when everyone gets hot because they know they don't have much time left. And so, if, I mean, if it keeps going the way it is, I mean, we're going to see upwards of 50 points. And in basketball, I love seeing that.
Yeah, that's always fun. I like to see those games where sometimes they run up there and it just goes back and forth and they get 70, 75 points. It's just fun to watch a team roll on all cylinders offensively. Logan Lewis, far side, will inbound to James Mobley. Mobley eventually gives it to Logan Lewis, who is pressured by Rohrer, and that ball is intercepted by the Lakes Community Eagles. McCure with it now. Ran into his own man. McCure with it. Gives it up. Kind of looked like a walk there to me. And they're out and running. And that bucket is good.
Ben Kusiak. That's his first two of this ball game.
Ben Kusiak gets that layup to go. Kyle Rohrer for three. Bang!
Fair to say that he's their three baller because that's his second of the day.
Only points have come off three for Kyle Rohrer. Haven't really seen his full potential, Ryan. He's a very good scorer of the basketball when he wants to be. Wow, that was one of the crazier shots we've seen so far today. Logan Lewis had no chance there. Rohrer with it now. Rohrer steps into another. No good. Kay with it, dribble drive, gives it up to Mobley. Mobley resets. Kusiak, a dribble drive, throws it up off the side of the backboard. Kay finally gets it. They're gonna call it an and one opportunity. Andy Kay, a good bucket.
Well, circus action.
Yeah. The circus shots. Okay, puts that one up, and that one falls for him. 35-28 in favor of the Grand High School Bulldogs. 5:55 remaining. No good there for Timothy Oline. Kerr puts it up, and that one is good for John Kerr.
Get to the paint, get to the basket, layups or circus shots, whatever pleases you, and you will take away with the lead. Now it's 37-28. 9-point lead for the Grant Bulldogs.
Yep, and they have come out and controlled this half. We're going to send this to a quick replay. There's the finish by John Kerr. And we are in the huddle right now with the Grant Bulldogs. What do you think you're saying if you're that coach?
Keep doing what we're doing and we're going to win.
It's simple. And they have controlled this right out of the gate, 9-point lead. Now what if you're that guy, the Lakes Community Eagles coach?
I always remember, I'm going to go back to the Grand Bulldog. When you are those people standing around the huddle, you're always trying to listen, but the whole time I feel like you're thinking, can I just get in, please? I mean, I know when I played for my team in high school, I mean, I know me and my buddies would just be joking around if we're not in the game and, like, get called in. There's only so much that coach can be talking about. Like, he's talking about a play that you probably already do know. So it's like, just say the name of the play and get going. Like, I know coaching sometimes is hard, but, like, at the same time, nice shot put up there. If only it did go, we can go back to this game. No one cares about me, so.
Cusack far side is going to put that one up, no good. Rebound by McCure. Three-pointer is thrown up, no good. Rebound controlled, and here comes Logan Lewis. Cusack with it. Lewis inside to Cusack, no good. Kerr tried to put it up, but he couldn't. He was getting bodied out, and hey, he's going to the line.
Like you just said, like your last thing you said right before you finished that sentence, and he got to the line. That's something early on in basketball that not a lot of people stress about how important getting to the line is. But those points are so free, so crucial. Yeah, I mean, they're just, I mean, that's, I guess, one can be one of the easiest things in basketball just to make free throws. But yet, you have so many people, like, even in the best league possible, the NBA, that are shooting 30%. And now it's coming down to the wire where a lot of teams are intentionally fouling those free throw shooters that aren't good, because they know as long as we don't have people foul out, if we can get them to shoot free throws, we're gonna win, or they're gonna score 10 less points per se.
Yeah. Nicholas Garcia puts that one up and in. No, but like a DeAndre Jordan, yes. I know what you're saying. Yeah, he shoots so poorly. I mean, he'll get a couple of fouls that you probably wouldn't get if you knew how to shoot a game. Just because they're saying he won't score it if we foul him, and then he won't make the free throws.
Yeah.
And a call a loose ball foul there on Andy Kay. Kyle Rohr will inbound. Halfway through the third quarter, 38-30 in favor of the Grant High School Bulldogs. They really need a run here, the Lakes team does, if they want to get back into this one. Shot is up, no good, rebound controlled, and here come the Bulldogs. Not a good showing by the Eagles so far, really, on offense. Coming out of the break, they've struggled to get the offensive going.
Yeah, they have, and Grant just kind of came out of the, they had a 5-point lead, so technically they've only gained a 3-point lead, but it does seem like it is all Grant in the second half so far. But I mean, one person that we need to look out for is still Jordan McCure. He doesn't have any points, and that's one thing that was big about the last game, that the leading scorer in the first half didn't do anything in the second half until late, and I don't want that to happen to the Lakes Community Eagles, because it's crucial that you get your stars going early on in the second half so they can light up.
Rohr definitely walked there. Some good encouragement there by Nicholas Garcia for Kyle Rohr. Really struggled to this point.
I'd like to see that, though. Good sportsmanship, even from your own team. Just confidence boosters and what have you not.
Oh, definitely stepped over the line there. Kyle Dupree, backcourt violation.
One thing I don't want to see happen in this basketball game right now, because there's been two kind of iffy plays going on, and I don't want that
to turn into a turnover.
Yeah, I don't want the last couple minutes of this quarter to turn into that. I mean, so far it's been really crisp basketball, and it's been fun to watch.
Rohr, a good pass there. Got to convert those good looks off of good passes. You really need those to fall. That was Christensen that couldn't convert.
I also think it's kind of funny when you see someone commit a foul, and then they put their hands up right away saying it wasn't them. Like, everyone saw you do it, buddy.
We have it on the tape.
Like, It's one thing if your hands are up the whole time, but a lot of people will commit a foul or push someone and they'll put their hands up right away. And it's like, the ref's right there. It's not like he's going to care if you put your hands up or not. I mean, I'm not saying I never did that. Everyone did it at some point. Everyone does it.
Everyone gets a little frustrated.
It's just funny to see it happen all the time because it's so true. And then the next person's hands go over, most likely the coaches.
What are you doing if you're the Lakes Community Eagles coach right now? What are you saying?
Honestly, just clean it up a little bit because they did force a turnover from Grant a couple possessions ago when I think it was Kyle Dupree stepped when he had a backcourt violation. So they are doing things well, but when they are on the offensive side, they're just not making baskets. It's simple. And I know I keep on saying it's simple over and over and over, but the method is simple. Doing it obviously is not simple because if it was simple, everyone would do it. But I mean, when you are within 5 feet of the basket, those are must makes.
Yeah, and especially any time that you run a set play or you get a good opportunity, a good look, anytime within 10 feet, you really need to start knocking at least some of those down.
Yeah.
Cusiak will dribble it up, and there's Walker. Quickly swung around. A three from Walker, that one hits, and Drew Walker.
Another three baller. That's his second of the day. Second three ball it is.
That's gonna make it tough. Putting them up by 11 with how they've been struggling. Makes it seem a lot harder than it did a second ago.
Well, that right there is what you want to see from Jordan Mercer. He didn't necessarily score, but he facilitated it.
Yep, and that was Christensen with the bucket there. Or I believe it was Christensen with the bucket. Actually, I believe that was John Kerr with the bucket there.
John Kerr?
Yeah, John. Or wait, I'm looking at the wrong roster.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Ian Halflinger with the bucket.
There we go. He's on the scoreboard for the first time also.
Roar for three.
There you go.
We missed a bucket down at the other end. We'll have to update you on that one in a minute. Good defense there. And McCure gets it. Garcia, dribble drive. They're going to call him on the walk. Left to right, here comes Logan Lewis. Drew Walker now. Inbounder will be Lewis. Gives it up. Quick swing to Walker for three. That's not the man you want to leave.
He's hot. Him and Kyle Rohr have been going back and forth for threes. They both have nine and three of them all from behind the arc.
That's a shot off the front rim. No good. It was tapped by Lewis right to Ian Halflinger.
The lead is still 9.
37-46 in favor of the Grant High School Bulldogs off of some hot shooting from Drew Walker.
Sure does not seem like it's a 9-point lead, though, for Grant.
No, it definitely seems like Lakes has played them a little bit closer.
Yeah.
There's a turnover, and the Eagles will take back over.
And with now there's 44.6 seconds left in the game, or not in the game, I should say, in the quarter. So I would go for that last shot. I mean, you're down 9, maybe get a 3-ball, you're down 6, coming out of into the quarter. Grant, or you have the possession at the quarter too. So that's in your favor.
And they throw that 3 up, no good, but Halflinger there to clean up the mess. He's had a good little stint to play here.
Yes.
6 points for Halflinger just in this little minute stretch that he's been off the bench.
That was a great play, but you don't want to give up a three now.
Yeah, definitely not even a bucket. You'd like to keep that lead down to that 7 margin you got now.
Yes.
Lewis dribbles around. He's looking for someone to give the ball to. Walker gives it up to Kusiak. He got 5 on the clock. Walker throws it inside. Dupree with an easy layup. That's exactly what you did not want to do.
Yep.
Kyle Dupree.
I mean, hey, but if you're Grant, though, way to execute.
Yeah, good execution play by the Grant Bulldogs for sure.
The scoring this quarter was fairly distributed for Grant.
Yeah, for sure. You got a replay of that last setup layup here. A little bit ahead there, but it was a good setup. We're gonna try to wind it back again. Let's see if we can get the whole thing in view here. Yeah, kind of iffy there, but you know, it was a good feed.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I mean, hey, when you are in that position, when you're Kyle Dupree, you really don't know how much. And then you don't know how much time you have left, so that's why that little, the frantic little putback is there, and that's why he kind of forced it, but, I mean, got the roll.
48-39. It's a 9-point game. What do you got to do to get back into it if your legs just chip at it or what?
I mean, I'd say the same thing when I came out of the timeout. I mean, they aren't really doing anything wrong. They're making baskets, but Grant's returning. So, I mean, you can't play harder defense because they're already playing decently hard defense right now. So, you just got to, every opportunity that you have, you just can't make a mistake. And I know it's hard to do that, but, I mean, that's.
Wow, scrappy little section there. Mobley's going to put up a quick one, and that one's going to go. A really good play by James Mobley. To flick that one up quickly with enough touch to get that one to fall. James Mobley, definitely a highlight player for Grant. McCure's gonna dribble. They're gonna call that a charge on Jordan McCure.
That's one thing that he did in the first quarter that made him so successful, that going baseline and trying to just move it up there. He had success with that in the first quarter, but he has been absolutely silent since the first quarter, or I'm sorry, since the first half. And this is, for those of you who do know him, the guy from the last game.
Michael Shelton.
Yeah, he did the same exact thing that is going on with McCure right now.
A big block there by McCure, and they retain possession. That's going to be a push on Rohrer. Inbounder will be Drew Walker. He will inbound to Logan Lewis. Lewis quickly gives it to Mobley. Mobley now. There's Drew Walker. Mobley drives baseline, nowhere to go. They don't mind a little bit of a time-consuming possession, though.
If you get a good look, which they did not, then it's a good thing. But
well, being up by 11, I don't think they would mind as well. Rohrer now with it inside, right back to him. Really need that. They've been ice cold since the start of the fourth quarter. And a rebound by Kusiak, and that's going to go up and in. And it's slowly running away from the Lakes Community Eagles.
Yeah, I think I'd have to say the same. I'd have to agree with you. Simply because what just happened in the last minute or so is Grant did really well with taking up a lot of time on the offensive end. But when you're coming back in your Lakes Community, that doesn't mean you have to come back and force a shot to even up the time. That just means you have to get a good look, because if they keep taking up time like that, then you might not get the best look this next time.
It's been a pretty rough second half for the Lakes Community Eagles. I mean, in that last quarter, we only saw them score. I mean, 14, and that's out of three guys. So that's pretty rough. That's tough to win a game when you're only getting scoring out of a couple of guys. And here comes McCure. McCure with a dribble drive, gives it into the corner, a step in three, and that was a really smooth transition there from Michael Barrett.
One thing that's hard to do, especially since he has not really shot all today, to come in the fourth quarter and just make a three, that's not easy.
And step into it so smoothly, it was a good transition there.
And one thing that I have forgot to mention is the foul trouble that Grant is in, because if they foul one more time, they're just giving Lakes free baskets.
Which could come down, it could be crucial.
And in the first half, we were worried about Lakes committing all the fouls.
Pass inside, a good defensive play there, and here come the Community Eagles. Behind the back dribble from Rohr, and he's going coast to coast, finds his man. Definitely gonna call a charge there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was trying to do there. I mean, he had a great look.
You got to do a better job of avoiding them there. I mean, you saw him from a mile away waiting for the charge.
Credit to Owen, though.
Yep, for sure.
Well, I'm sorry. Took the charge? Yeah, I think that was Mobley. We're getting our names mixed up over here. Well, not perfect.
Drew Walker with it, gives it up to Logan Lewis. Dupree on the far side. And they are just kind of running some time down here. On the floor. Foul on Kyle Rohr.
Oh, I'm sorry. They are in foul trouble. I thought I was looking at the scoreboard way around.
I thought it was the other way.
Yeah, now I'd say if just,
it's if they start knocking down free throws, this could be big trouble.
10 points. 10 points with how the game's been played. I mean, hey, prove me wrong, but I'm gonna. You know my opinion.
Step in three again, and that one was smooth again for Michael Barron. Only guy who can shoot the three and the only guy who can score in this quarter, Michael Barron steps in and knocks it down.
Remember earlier, he had trouble with keeping the ball inbounds. He was the one that was stepping outside out of bounds, I think, a couple times, but sure making up for what he did.
McCure now with it, and he's just going to lay that one in easily.
I guess I'm just supposed to doubt everyone. They're going to do well then.
He said, prove me wrong, and apparently they heard.
Prove me wrong, Lakes.
That's a 5-0 run. We got a replay of that breakaway layup by Jordan McCure.
See, in my opinion, I wanted him to get up there and just slam it. But that's just because I'm a viewer, too, just like all you out there watching on YouTube.
Yep, you guys all wanted him to throw that one down with it with some force, but Jordan McCure decided to take the easy way. If you're up by 10 and you try to throw it down, okay. But if you're down by 7,
and you don't really have a crowd, so it's kind of like almost for self-confidence. Like, yeah, I can throw down.
I mean, we got a sizable crowd here, and the gym is slowly going to just start filling up as the night goes along. Consolation championships all day, third place game, and then the nightcap will be the championship game. So we've got full action here. Logan Lewis is gonna try to slow the roll of the Community Eagles here. 47-52 in favor of the Grant Bulldogs.
One thing that would really kill is fouls.
Almost had a turnover there. Colton Jewell on the far side wing. A turnover there could have said the wheels are scrambling here, because that would have been their second consecutive turnover. Lewis. Some pretty nifty dribbling at the top there. Oh, what a find!
That was impressive.
What a find, Logan Lewis. Give and go to give and go.
That was nice.
McCure with the answer. And a quick one at that. Jordan McCure.
Where was he in the third quarter?
Once again, might be a fourth quarter or a third quarter drought that curses a team. 54-49 here in the Jacobs High School gym. Just about 3 minutes remain on the clock. It's the Grant High School Bulldogs leading the game, but the Community Eagles are making a charge.
Well, keep away, I see.
Yep, they're definitely playing a little bit of clock, and can you blame them? Oh, that's a bad foul there. Another thing is, in the NBA and college, you do shot clock math in your head, possessions. How many possessions do you have remaining in the game, you know? Here, you can have any sort of limited possessions because there is no shot clock. So if a team effectively plays keep away the whole quarter, effectively that's fair game. So
in my opinion or my perspective on it, what I think will happen in the near future within the next 5 years is they will add a 45 or 50 second shot clock. It's not going to be anything. It's going to be a long shot clock, but you can't hold the ball with 2 minutes left and they're a minute left on the clock. Like you're at some point you're going to have to pass or shoot or create a turnover or something.
It will keep the flow of the game moving for sure.
Yeah.
Kyle Rohr with it now. 56-49. Really need a big bucket here. Going to call a push foul on Logan Lewis.
And I honestly believe that's a good foul. That's the third foul this half. And that's, I mean, why
not use them?
I mean, they have three left to give. So if you use one every so often, even if it's before someone shoots, it's just like they can't get a shot off then.
Barrett for three, knocks it down. Michael Barrett.
My next question is, where was he the rest of the game?
Michael Barrett, 52-56 now.
He's a shooter.
Yep, need to pressure the ball for sure, try to create some turnovers. Hopefully no foul. That's going to be off on them, and the chance has arisen, that's for sure, for this lead to be narrowed down to a one-possession game. A really good quarter for Michael Barrett. Timeout called. So what are you saying to your team now if you're the Grant Bulldogs?
Now I believe it is it their possession or is it Lake's?
Lake's possession.
So Lake's possession. So they're going to most likely take about 20, if the most they'll take off the clock is 20 seconds. Because they know if they miss, then they're down by four with about a minute 20 left. And so the whole keep away thing, then the fouls might start coming into play. So, I mean, you just got to get a really, really good shot. And if you're Grant, you have to play well. Like, you have fouls to give. So if you feel free and if you feel like you're going to give up a basket.
Or if you're the Grant Community High School Bulldogs.
One good thing that Lakes Community does have, though, they do have three timeouts left, whereas Grant only has one. So if they are in trouble, feel free to use a timeout. Yeah, a minute 40 left, so let's see how this one plays out here.
Yeah, we could have a close one here. Could have a barn burner here. Kyle Rohr gives it up to Barron. He's going to fire for three. No good. Rebound controlled. Are they calling that a charge?
They are.
That was a very, very weak call.
I'm not in the stripes, but I don't agree with it.
Wow, I really do not agree with that. That was a questionable call, to say the least. That was very questionable. Got to pressure the ball for sure.
No fouls to give either.
Yep, no fouls to give. So what time are you thinking about fouling at? Oh, you can't give him that. Oh, and he missed it. Oh, wow, that was a lucky break. Get it to the only guy who can really score it this quarter, Michael Barrett. Kyle Rohr for three, no good. Tapped around, controlled. They tried to throw it off him and it went through his legs. 52 seconds remain and it's going to be interesting how this one plays out. And they got a 4-on-1 break. They're gonna call a foul there. Can't blame them for fouling on that.
Well, I think it's safe to say that they did not prove me wrong.
Need a couple misses here to keep it in. 41 seconds remain.
Hey, I mean, what did I say at half? I said I think it'd be a upper 50s game.
Yeah, I mean, you're getting there. Kay at the line knocks the first one down, and that's going to be a crucial free throw for the Grant Bulldogs. Second one is up, and that one also falls. Really need a three now.
Yeah.
You know who to get it to.
I just stay with who's taking it up.
Roar for three. Bang! Kyle Roar!
It's impressive, though. Honestly, when it comes down to the wire like this, you are put in a spot that you have to make it. I mean, that in high school, that's not easy. And that, there's only three. Grant only has a three-point lead.
Yeah. Heck of a quarter by the Lakes Community Eagles on offense and on defense.
What were they down by at half? They were down 30 to 25, so they were down five. They cut the lead. They've cut it to two so far.
They were down by nine going into this quarter, so they've done a good job to narrow this gap for sure.
I mean, throughout the course of the game, they've been down the whole time. At the end of the first quarter, it was 12-11. They were down by one, then they were down by five, then they were down by nine. So, I mean, through all the times they've been down, to only be down three with about 30 seconds left, I mean, if Grant screws up, I mean, it's a possibility.
Yeah, watch out. All they've really got to do is get the ball in, and they're going to foul.
It's not in the books yet, even though I've said it like five times, I think it is.
They might prove you wrong.
Just a dumb college kid.
So. 58-55, 29.9 seconds remain, so just about the 30 ticks on the clock. Lewis will inbound. They get it in, and they're running the same break that they ran pretty much the whole game. They got it dead. Trapping on the far side.
That was almost 10 seconds. I was close to saying eight, because in college and in the NBA, it's 8 seconds, but that was close.
Yeah, look at 29.9 was on the clock. Now it's 20.5, so.
They had a second. Not even a second to give.
That was very close. I mean, if they don't commit a foul there. Yeah, that's close. That's a tough one. Oh, and they missed the first one. Now, if this one doesn't go down, give them the chance.
I mean, you have to.
Oh, my Lord. 20.5 left on the clock.
Let's see where the ice
Kusiak
is at.
Kusiak, let's see if he can knock it down, and he does. A lucky bounce. Really need a three and then some help yet again. Colton Jewell for three. He knocks it down. Colton Jewell.
Who is he?
This team has shot the ball extremely well. 58-59 now.
Foul.
He got a foul right away.
Now I know what to do.
Foul. He got a foul right away, and then
two shots. That's what's not in your favor, though. They do get two shots because they are in the double bonus.
Yeah, but if they do miss one, I mean, even if they don't, they've hit three consecutive three-pointers in a row.
But I mean, it's the one guy that hasn't hit yet in the last couple shots. Number 22.
Michael Baird.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, get him the ball.
I don't know who. Okay, I had no idea that Colton Jewell could shoot.
Yeah, me neither. So I didn't know he could knock it down.
I thought that was one of those things where you have no time left, so you put your post out there and you shoot, but I was mistakenly wrong. But he knocked it down.
From the bench, I heard a yell of Colton, and he knocked that bad boy down.
If you're Grant, would you or would you not tag Michael Burnett?
Anytime. Okay, so if I'm Grant, all I'm focused on is getting the ball in bounds. If you can get the ball in bounds.
I'm saying once after, like, obviously they talked about the two sides of the ball. They didn't just talk about offense.
Yeah, if Barron gets a good look, you're in trouble. So, I mean, if you got fouls to give, tag a guy if you have to. I mean, if you really need to, you can go and you can get after a guy. Questionable, not fouling right away there. Wasted four could be precious seconds, because in high school you can't advance the ball with timeouts.
Correct.
So that's
whereas the NBA, that's one thing I never understand. I mean, obviously I understand because I know basketball, but like,
I don't understand why you couldn't advance it in high school.
I don't agree with it, I'd say.
Cusiak knocks it down.
This has definitely been one of the most fun games to announce this year.
Yeah, this has been a good one.
Upward 60. That one I was right on. Or upwards 50, I should say.
Second one is good, and it's a three-point deficit, so they got to hustle. They got to really hustle. They call the timeout with 1.2 remaining. What kind of inbounds play are you drawing up? Who's it for?
Well,
call a number.
Can't do the whole alley-oop thing, so you have to get someone open. And if it's needed, they have one timeout left. So if
the play doesn't work,
when you're telling your players, if this doesn't work, call timeout.
Yeah.
If you're at 4 seconds, call timeout, because we can get another look. This is for the game. This is for the championship.
If the consolation beat championship right here. If what you're saying is if the first play they draw up doesn't work,
come back and
we'll draw another one up, because we still got another chance to do that with the timeout remaining.
Yeah, come back and wake us announcers, wait for what's going to happen in the next 1.2 seconds.
They might not have one. I think that's the visitors
out
with the timeout, so this play has to be right.
They about 30 seconds ago, they just took away that timeout. So we're wrong again. Sorry, folks.
So if you did have a timeout, that would be the ideal.
Yes.
But nevertheless, here's the inbounds play that will determine the game. For three in the win, and it's a tie!
No way!
Kyle Rohr knocks it down to tie the game!
No way!
And they're celebrating like they won!
No way!
But he knocked it down!
You have to be kidding me!
Woo!
Wow! I said it first, but wow.
And we got the replay of this one. We got a good replay here coming for you. What a shot. Nothing but the twine.
Just, wow.
That is what we live for right there.
Thank you, Lakes community, for proving me wrong. I am wrong once again.
Wow. OT.
This reminds me of when me and you were back at the good old Elgin High School doing games about a year ago, man.
Okay, so we got the same play, different look at it now. So this is definitely a good angle.
I thought there was no way.
Yeah, I didn't think there was any way that one was going to fall. And
So if 8 minutes times four was not enough for you guys on YouTube, we'll give you four more.
Yep, this is free basketball. I mean, it all is, but, you know, if you paid to enter, free basketball for you. Here comes Grant. How do you recover from that?
You play. Oh, but here we go.
Oh, wow.
Look at this. This is where fouls can eat you alive. See?
That was a bad foul there.
Hey, but you know what? This whole, like, shooting the three every time you get on the court, why don't you just keep doing it? It's kind of fun to watch.
We got to add a column here. OT.
Yeah, I'm putting that in my final.
Kay throws that one up and misses.
But, I mean, seriously, though, they've hit every three they went down there, like, on the last five possessions they've hit.
Yeah, they did. They made a lot of clutch shots.
I'm not going to be that announcer like a lot of people hate the pros that say, oh, I hate to see him go cold now, but.
Yeah, but.
I'm not saying it, so. You can't even really do a play-by-play anymore. It's more of just like an unremarkable game.
Oh, that's a crucial Barrett travel there. The guys hit clutch shot after clutch shot and moved the feet a bit early. You know, the thing is about basketball, the last couple minutes can take an hour.
You can say that again.
Cusiak's going to drive in. Oh, how'd that get through? James Mosley.
He's been quiet. He is back.
James Mosley knocks down a three, and that was a big one, that's for sure.
Now they're back to a four-point lead.
Yep, and just like that, the Heroics have stopped. That's going to be off on a red jersey.
Okay, now get it to what's been working for the last 3 minutes.
Yeah, you can't just...
Don't go back to what you did in the first quarter.
You got to stick with what's worked, that's for sure. I mean, no miracle shots, you don't need them, but good looks. Barron sets his feet and fires back rim. Jewel definitely traveled there, got away with one. Roar for three. And you cursed him, Ryan, you did.
No, I didn't say it.
You hate to see him go cold now, huh?
But
Timothy Olwine.
But what? I didn't say it. I swear. I mean, that's just the tail of the game. You knew that was going to happen. You know they
eventually,
can't,
yeah.
You know they can't be hot every minute of the game. It's high school. Even in the pros, it's not what happens.
Even Steph Curry has a bad night every now and then. Mobley with it now.
Just one game out of 27 or 28. Man, that team's unbelievable.
Yeah, that's a...
What do you think they can do it?
We'll have plenty of time to talk about that, me and you. Andy K puts that one up and in. I think that they're a good team. I don't know what they're capable of quite yet, but they can beat pretty much about everybody they face. Roar puts that one up, and he gets the foul. Kyle Roar.
The thing about that team, Golden State, the thing about them is that last year there were so many critics. We can talk about Golden State right after we get this replay of that and one.
Yeah, good shot by Kyle Roar. All right.
But, I mean, what they've done this year is, last year there were so many critics saying that they couldn't do it. They couldn't. They weren't good enough because the Cavs weren't healthy. And to do what they did yesterday, win on Christmas Day, I think it shut up a lot of people and just proved to the country and the world how good they really were.
66-67 here in the Jacobs High School gym, and that's a big bucket there by Ben Cusiak. 3-point game. Never safe in this one. Oh, Kyle Roar went to the bucket. Roar now needs these two to fall for sure. First one is up and it is good for Kyle Roar. What a second half for him. It appears to me that we are sending it to a replay of the foul. Oh, and a definite lane violation there on the grand side, and that's
great.
Crucial.
Yeah, he's missing because he missed it. What's the rule on that? If you were to make that,